Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Agilent Technologies, and today we're going to take a look at the web UI that's featured in our new Truevolt series of multimeters. The Truevolt multimeters have a full-featured web UI. The software runs on the multimeter, so no additional software is required on your PC, just a web browser. Any changes that are made to the front panel of the multimeter will be reflected in the web UI. Any changes we make in the web UI will reflect on the front panel. Let's go ahead and take a look. On the bench, the web UI is really helpful for capturing and sharing results. So my setup is I just have a LAN cable going from the instrument to my PC. I've put the IP address into my web browser, and so I'm connected to the instrument. I'm going to start by bringing up the first two panels in the web UI, the monitor DMM panel and the control DMM panel. So the first thing I want to demonstrate is by changing the front panel of the instrument, I'm going to switch it to AC volts. We can see the web UI is updated with the front panel of the instrument. I'm going to go ahead and switch back the front panel instrument. And again, the web UI is updated. So as you can see, we have a signal that's a 4-volt DC signal with some AC ripple riding on top of it. The next thing I want to demonstrate on the web UI is the ability to add statistics to our display. So it's real simple to add statistics to our display on the web UI. Now I'm going to go ahead and control the DMM using the web UI. So I'm going to leave it with DC volts, but what I want to do is I want to increase the reading rate. So I'm going to do that by lowering the resolution of the DMM. So I'm going to go ahead and make that change. A really nice thing feature of the web UI is that I can go ahead and bring back any of the graphical displays of the Truevolt multimeter. So I'm going to start by bringing back the trend chart so you can see what that looks like. So it looks like a DC volt, but we can see that there's a little something going on there as well, in addition to the DC volts. So that's our AC ripple that we're seeing. I'm going to go ahead now and switch to the histogram, and you can very clearly see the AC signal riding on top of the DC in the histogram mode. So programmers will also really like the web UI in that you can actually bring up the Skippy commands that are being generated by the web UI. So from here, you can just go in and cut and paste the Skippy commands and put it into your own program. Another nice feature about the web UI is that you could use it over the LAN network, and so you could have an experiment set up remotely, and you could bring back the data to your web UI while your experiment's running. So you could check on your experiment remotely. So as an example, what I'd like to show is I'd like to, again, show our histogram. I'm going to go ahead and clear it on the front panel, and I want to show you the histogram as it gets more and more data. What you'll see is you'll see it get updated. So it starts off pretty blocky. We'll go ahead and get a new display of it as it updates. Gets more and more data and more details in the histogram. This is also true with the trend chart. So if we have an experiment set up over time, we can see the trend chart as it's being built. So another nice feature is for checking on remote experiments with the web UI. The last thing I wanted to demonstrate was you can also store and recall states. So if you have a particular setup of the DMM that you want to save, you can go ahead and save it and recall it remotely from the web UI. Remember, the web UI is built into the instrument and requires no additional software. You can use it remotely over the LAN or through a direct connection to your PC. Thanks for watching.